Europa. Now, these genuses, these genuses comes under where? Family Solanaceae. So, Solanum, Petunia, Datura, Atropa, etc. genuses or genera belongs to the family Solanaceae. They are belonging to which family? Solanaceae. If we are saying that in animals, so in animals such as a lion was there, leopard were there, tiger were there, jaguar were there. So we have to see that. Another example, in animals, lions, tiger, leopard, jaguar. So these animals are coming and they belongs to family Felidae. So these are belongs to family Felidae. They belongs to which family? Felidae. Now, if we are seeing the common rules and regulations, so always we are seeing what? In plants. In plants, family ends with AC. In plants, family ends in the suffix AC. So what we can say that is important? In plants, family ends with suffix AC. Solanaceae, Poaceae, Malvaceae, many are there. So ends with what? Suffix AC. And if we are taking about animals, we are taking about animals, so they are coming suffix what? ID. And in case of animals, family ends with suffix. There, what suffix are they coming? ID. Here it came, Felidae. EAE. So this is what regarding with family. Now, next hierarchy that above top, from this family, so that is order. Come on that. So next hierarchy is order. Till yet we discuss what species, genus, family. Now order is what? It is a assembling of different families. What we can say? It is assemblage of families. What is that? It is group of families, or it is assemblage of families. It is assemblies of families resembling one another in few characters. So it is assemblies of families resembling one another, in few characters. So what we are seeing that while going from below to top, bottom to top, common characters decreases. That is saying resembling one another in few characters. So here what happens? common characters are decreasing. If we are seeing that example, so come on that example. For example, family is what we have seen, Malvaceae. Okay, Malvaceae, mustard group, then Tiliaceae, Sterculiaceae. So Malvaceae, Tiliaceae, Sterculiaceae. Now these are having what? Family, and that belong to order Malvaceae. So belongs to order Malvaceae. Okay, they are belonging to order Malvaceae. Why they are having, what is their common characters? So common characters, they are showing exile placentation in the ovary. That we will see in morphology of flowering plants in next chapter. Okay, so it is having common in what? So common character, what is that common character? Exile placentation in ovary. Okay, so this Malvaceae, Tiliaceae, Sterculiaceae, okay, that belongs to order what? Malvaceae. Similarly, if we are coming on, so next example is Rosaceae. Rose family, Rosaceae, it is rose family. So Rosaceae is there. Leguminaceae, that is pea family. Leguminaceae, it is what? Pea family. Okay, so Leguminaceae. Okay, Leguminaceae. Now these two belongs to order what? Rosaceae. So belongs to order, and that order is Rosaceae. It is Rosaceae. Now what is the common character here? Perigynous flower. What is that? Perigynous flower. So it is Perigynous flower and marginal placentation. These all term we will see in next chapters. Okay, so Perigynous flower, marginal placentation, this is the common in where? Order Rosaceae. Okay, now if we are seeing another one, another examples are there, like in animals. So in there, if you are seeing, so order Carnivora. Order Carnivora. Now this Carnivora contains families. What are the families are there? One is Canidae. One is Felidae. Okay, so Canidae is there, Felidae is there, Ursidae. Okay, so these families comes under which order? Carnivora. Okay, now if we are seeing the common rule, so order ends with suffix -ales where? In plants. And in case of animals, different suffix are used, so no proper rules are there. But in plants, it is -ales. So what we can say? What we can say? In case of plants, order ends with, in case of plants, order ends with the suffix. And what was the suffix? -ales. Okay. And in animals, different type of suffixes are used, so no proper rules are there. Okay. Now after that order. Next is subclass. Okay. Next it should be class, but sometime some questions are asking from subclass. That's why I am telling. But if ascending order or descending order is there, so you have to remember according to the keep pot clean, otherwise family get sick. So next is subclass. Come on that. Subclass. Next higher category is subclass. So what is subclass? It is assemblage of different orders, because orders we discuss now. So it is an assemblage of different orders. It is what? Assemblage of different orders having some common similarity, because while going up, common similarity decreases. So having some common similarity. Okay, so that is coming under where? Subclass. Okay, now if we are telling that example, so polypetaly. Polypetaly means what? Poly means free. So free petals. Gamopetaly. Gamopetaly means what? Fused petals. So for example, polypetaly means free petals. Gamopetaly means fused petals. Okay, so this polypetaly, gamopetaly, okay, this is containing, what are the orders are there? Malvelis are there. So what we can say, the order Malvelis. Already we know Elis will come. So Malvelis, Renalis, Periatalis. So Malvelis, Renalis, Periatalis. Okay. So Malvelis, Renalis, Periatalis, Peritalis. Okay. Peritalis. So this order belongs to the subclass, and that is subclass is polypetaly. So this is having subclass. Similarly, Astralis, come on that order. Astralis. Okay, next is polymonialis. Okay, so Astralis, polymonialis, okay, that contain what? Fused petals, and that comes under subclass. What is that subclass? Gamopetaly. So gamopetaly. Okay, so now we understood what is a subclass. Okay, now next we have to come on next hierarchy, that is class. So come on that class. So next hierarchy is class. Now, as we already seen in species, genus, family, order, subclass, so same like class definition is there. So it is what? It is a taxonomic category made up of one or more related orders or subclass. What we can say? It is a taxonomic category. It is a taxonomic category made up of related subclass or orders, okay, which contain very few similar characters, which contain very few similar characters, because as a move from bottom to top, common characters decreases. Okay, so that is known as what? Class. Now come on their example. For example, one class is there, that is a mammalia. Now this mammalia contains orders. What are the orders are there? So mammalia class mammalia contains order. Now what are the orders they are containing? Like carnivora, already we discussed, rodentia. So order carnivora, rodentia, rodents are there inside that, so rodentia, insectivora, etc. Insectivora, etc. So that is coming under where? Class mammalia. Next, if we are discussing regarding plants, so class monocotyledonae, class monocotyledonae. Okay, so class monocotyledonae. Okay, class monocotyledonae. So it contains, what are the, they are containing subclass Araceidae. What is that? Araceidae, Alismatidae. So contain subclass Araceidae. Okay, they are containing subclass Araceidae, Alismatidae. Alismatidae. Okay, so this is coming under which class? Monocotyledonae. If we are discussing about dicotyledonae, so class dicotyledonae, class dicotyledonae contains subclass that we discuss now. What was that? Gamopetalae. What was that another one? Polypetalae. Okay, so gamopetalae, polypetalae, this is where that class was dicotyledonae. Now this class always ends with suffix ac. What is that? Phyce. Phyce. Class ends with what? Phyce. Family ends with what? Ac. So what we can say? Ends with suffix phyce. Okay, that is ends with what? Phyce or opsida. Okay, phyce is there, opsida is there, and ae. And these phyce, opsida, ae in plants only, because animals don't have any particular rule for ending suffix. Okay, so this all belongs to what? Class. Okay, now in the next class we will discuss phylum, division, and kingdom. Okay, thank you.